السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، وما يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة. الحمد لله. We praise Allah and we seek His assistance and we seek His forgiveness. And we seek refuge with Allah from the evil within ourselves and from our bad deeds. Wherever Allah guides, there is none that can lead him astray, and whoever is led astray, and there is no guide for him. I bear witness that no God has the right to be worshipped other than Allah. He is alone and has no partners, and I bear witness that Muhammad is His slave and His messenger. O you who believe, fear Allah as He ought to be feared, and don't die except as Muslims. O humanity, fear your Lord who has created you from a single soul and created from it its mate and scattered from them too many men and women. And fear Allah through whom you demand your mutual rights, and don't cut off relations with the wounds that bore you. Indeed, Allah is a raqib, a watcher over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say that which is correct, in order that He may accept from you your deeds and forgive you of your sins, and whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger achieves the greatest achievement. Amma ba'du. Certainly the most truthful speech is the book of Allah, and the finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most evil of affairs are newly invented matters in the deen, and every newly invented matter in the deen is a bid'ah, and every bid'ah is a straying. Brothers and sisters in Islam, fear Allah and read the Quran. And let's continue with the poem of Abu Bakr al-Sijistani rahimahullah, as he says, وَإِنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ لِلْخَلْقِ شَافِعٌ وَقُلْ فِي عَذَابِ الْقَبْرِ حَقٌّ مُوَضَّحٌ وَلَا تُكْفِرَنْ أَهْلَ الصَّلَاةِ وَإِنْ عَصَوْا فَكُلُّهُمْ يَعْصِي وَذُو الْعَرْشِ يَصْفَحُ وَلَا تَعْتَقِدْ رَأْيَ الْخَوَارِجِ إِنَّهُ مَقَالٌ لِمَنْ يَهْوَاهُ يُرْدِي وَيَفْضَحُ ولا تكن مرجيا لعوبا بدينه ألا إنما المرجي بالدين بالدين يمزح. وقل إنما الإيمان قول ونية وفعل على قول النبي مصرح، وينقص طورا بالمعاصي وتارة بطاعته ينما وفي الوزن يرجح.
Last week we were with the statement, indeed the Messenger of Allah is an intercessor for the people. Meaning the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam intercedes on behalf of the Muslims who have committed major sins so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives them and saves them from the fire. We ended with his statement and say, pertaining to the punishment of the grave, it is the truth and it is clear. And we see this in the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha. قالت سألت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن عذاب القبر فقال نعم عذاب القبر حق. قالت عائشة رضي الله عنها فما رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يصلي بعد إلا تعوذ من عذاب القبر. أخرجه النسائي وصححه الألباني. On the authority of Aisha رضي الله عنها, she said, I asked the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم about the punishment in the grave. He said, yes, the punishment in the grave is true. Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, I never saw the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam offering salat after that, except that he would seek refuge with Allah from the punishment of the grave. Collected authentically by An-Nasa'i and authenticated as Sahih by Al-Albaniyyu. We follow the example of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We believe in the punishment of the grave, and we seek refuge with Allah to protect us from the punishment of the grave every time we offer salat as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us. And the next line he says, وَلَا تُكْفِرَنْ أَهْلَ الصَّلَاتِ وَإِنْ عَصَوْا فَكُلُّهُمْ يَعْصِي وَذُو الْعَرْشِ يَصْفَحُ. And do not consider the people of the salah disbelievers, kufar, because they commit acts of disobedience. Because all of them commit acts of disobedience, but the owner of the throne overlooks. The people of the salah are the Muslims, so do not consider them disbelievers because they commit sins. We see this in the hadith of Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man salla salatana wa istaqbala qiblatana wa akala dhabihana fa dhalika al-muslim alladhi lahu dhimmatullahi wa dhimmatu rasulihi fala tukhfirullaha fi dhimmatihi. Akhrajahu al-Bukhari. On the authority of Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever offers our salat, prays our salat, faces our qibla, and eats from our slaughter, then that is the Muslim. He is the one who has the protection of Allah and the protection of His Messenger. So do not violate Allah in His protection. Collected by Imam Bukhari. وعن جابر رضي الله عنه قال سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن بين الرجل والشرك والكفر ترك الصلاة. أخرجه مسلم. On the authority of Jabir رضي الله عنه, he said, I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, indeed, that which is between a man and shirk and kufr is the leaving off of the salah. Collected by Imam Muslim. This shows that the Muslims are the people of the salat, even if the Muslim commits sins and acts of disobedience. Even if a Muslim is negligent in his salat, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of us, then the Muslim is a Muslim, and the Muslim is not considered to be a disbeliever because of his sins and his acts of disobedience. قال المخدجي رحمه الله أنه سمع رجلا من أهل الشام يدعى أبا محمد يقول الوتر واجب. قال المخدجي رحت إلى عبادة بن الصامت رضي الله عنه فأخبرته فقال عبادة كذب أبو محمد سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول خمس صلوات كتبهن الله على العباد فمن جاء بهن ولم يضيع شيئا منهن استخفافا بحقهن كان له عند الله عهد أن يدخله الجنة، وإن لم يأتي بهن ليس له عند الله عهد، إن شاء عذبه وإن شاء أدخله الجنة. أخرجه أبو داود وغيره وصححه الألباني. On the authority of Al-Makhdaji رحمه الله, he said that he heard a man from Sham, they called him Abu Muhammad, that he said Al-Witru wajibun, meaning to offer the witr salat is a religious obligation, alluding to the fact that if you don't do it, your Islam is in question. Allah knows best. So he said, I went to Al-Ubad ibn Samit radiallahu anhu. And this is the way to learn our religion. We go to the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they teach us our religion. As Ubad rahimahullah, he said, Abu Muhammad has not spoken the truth. I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, when we take our religion to the companions, they take it back to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, there are five salat that Allah has written down and decreed for the slaves. Whoever does them without being negligent in them or undermining their importance or giving them their rights, the salat, then he has a covenant with Allah that Allah will enter him into Jannah. But if he does not do the salat properly, or he does not come with the salat, or he's negligent in his salat, then he does not have a covenant with Allah. If Allah likes, he will punish him, and if Allah likes, he will enter him into paradise. This hadith is collected authentically by Abu Dawood. We see here that we do not consider the Muslims, the people of the salat, to be disbelievers because they commit sins. All of them commit sins, and the possessor of the throne overlooks. Allah Ta'ala, he says, وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الْوَدُودُ ذُو الْعَرْشِ الْمَجِيدُ فَعَالُ لِمَا يُرِيدُ. Allah Ta'ala, he says, and he is Al-Ghafoor, the forgiving, Al-Wadood, the loving, ذُو الْعَرْشِ, the possessor and owner of the throne, Al-Majidu, the glorious, or the noble. He does whatever he wills. And Allah Ta'ala pardons for those who commit sins, as he teaches us with his statement, وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Al-Ayah, where Allah Ta'ala, he says, and I command you to pardon and overlook. Pardon, meaning don't criticize and blame someone for their sin and acts of disobedience. And overlook, meaning don't punish them for their sin and their act of disobedience. Don't you love that Allah would forgive you? And Allah is the forgiving, the merciful. Allah forgives, meaning the believers, they commit sins and acts of disobedience, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wipes it away by not blaming and criticizing them and by not punishing them, except that he forgives them, as he says in his book. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who seek his forgiveness. He continues as he says, وَلَا تَعْتَقِدْ رَأْيَ الْخَوَارِجِ إِنَّهُ مَقَالٌ لِمَنْ يَهْوَاهُ يُرْضِي وَيَفْضَحُ. He said, and do not believe with the opinion of the Khawarij, because it's based on lowly desires and it exposes the one who holds this position of deviant belief, or as he intends by his statement. Here he speaks against the Khawarij. And the Khawarij are the people who say that the Muslims are disbelievers because of their committing of acts of disobedience and major sins. But we see in the narration of Usair ibn Amr rahimahullah, qala qultu li Sahl ibn Hunayf, hal sami'ta min an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi al-khawarij shay'an? قال سمعته يقول ويهوى بيده وأهوى بيده قبل العراق، فقال يخرج منه قوم يقرؤون القرآن لا تجاوز تراقيهم، يمرقون من الإسلام مروق السهم من الرمية. أخرجه البخاري. On the authority of Usayr ibn Amr rahimahullah, he said, I asked Sahal ibn Hunayf, did you hear the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam saying anything concerning the Khawarij? Remember, this is how we learn our religion. We ask the Tabi'een, we ask the Sahaba, we ask the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and then he clarifies for us. He said, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam saying, as he was motioning in the direction of Iraq, he said, people will come from here, they will read the Quran, it won't go past their collarbones, meaning they won't understand it properly. They'll go through Islam just like the hunter's arrow goes right through the bird, collected by al-Bukhari. Don't take the position of the Khawarij. They are deviant, they went too far by considering the Muslims to be disbelievers because they commit acts of disobedience, and that the Muslims will be in the fire of hell, abiding there and forever. That's one deviant position. Here Abu Bakr As-Sijistani rahimahullah, he shows the other extreme as he says, وَلَا تَكُمْ مُرْجِيًّا لَعُوبًا لِدِينِهِ أَلَا إِنَّمَا الْمُرْجِيُّ بِالدِّينِ يَمْزَحُ. He said, do not be a murjia who's playing with his religion, because the murjia, they only play with the religion. The murjia are the people who say, so long as you say I believe, you don't have to do anything, and you'll be from the people of paradise of Jannah, and you'll never be punished with the hellfire. We see in the narration of Zubayd rahimahullah, قال سألت أبا وائل عن المرجئة فقال حدثني عبد الله أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال سباب المسلم فسوق وقتاله كفر. متفق عليه. On the authority of Zubayd rahimahullah, he said, I asked Abu Wa'il rahimahullah about the murji'a. He said, Abdullah, the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ibn Mas'ud, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, insulting a Muslim is fusuq, defiant disobedience, and fighting a Muslim is kufr. Collected by al-Bukhari and Muslim. Even though you're a Muslim, if you commit major sins and acts of disobedience to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it affects your iman. Because your iman is not just a belief in your heart and a statement on your tongue, but it's actions with its body parts. And it increases with acts of obedience, and it decreases with acts of disobedience. As Abu Bakr As-Sijistani continues with this poem, as he says, وَقُلْ إِنَّمَا الْإِيمَانُ قَوْلٌ وَنِيَّةٌ وَفِعْلٌ عَلَى الْقَوْلِ النَّبِيِّ مُصَرَّحُ وَيَنْقُصُ طَوْرًا بِالْمَعَاصِي وَتَارَةً بِطَاعَتِهِ يَنْمَى وَفِي الْوَزْنِ يَرْجَحُ. He says, and say that iman or faith is a statement and a belief and an action based on the clear statement of the Prophet. It decreases with acts of disobedience at one hand, at some times, and at other times it is increased with the acts of obedience, and it's weighty in the scales, meaning in the sight of Allah. And we see this in the hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الإيمان بضع وسبعون شعبة أفضلها قول لا إله إلا الله وأدناها إماتة الأذى عن الطريق والحياء شعبة من الإيمان. أخرجه مسلم. On the authority of Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه, he said that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, iman or faith or belief is 70 some branches. The best branch is the statement لا إله إلا الله, that there is no God but Allah. And the lowest branch of faith is to remove something harmful from the pathway. And al-haya, or modesty and shame, is a part of faith. This is collected by Al-Bukhari. Your shyness from your heart for this disposition of yours is faith. Removing something from the pathway that's harmful, your action is your faith. And your statement that you believe that there's no God but Allah is your faith. Because your faith is a belief and a statement and an action. And we also see this in the hadith of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu, qala qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من رأى منكم منكرا فيغيره بي فليغيره بيده فإن لم يستطع فبلسانه فإن لم يستطع فبقلبه وذلك أضعف الإيمان. أخرجه مسلم on the authority of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri رضي الله عنه. He said that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever amongst you sees a wrong, change it with his hand. And if he can't, change it with his tongue, meaning speak against it. And if he can't, hate it in his heart. And that's the weakest part of Iman. That's the weakest part of faith. And this faith, it increases and decreases. As we see from Allah Ta'ala's statement, هُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ فِي قُلُوبِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ لِيَزْدَادُوا إِيمَانًا مَعْ إِيمَانِهِمْ. And it is he who has sent the tranquility down upon the heart, he is the one who has sent down the tranquility upon the hearts of the believers to increase belief along with their belief. Our belief, it increases with good deeds and it decreases with bad deeds. Sometimes we have a lot of belief and sometimes we have less. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to be from amongst the true believers. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. I said what I had to say and I seek forgiveness for myself and for you and for all of the Muslims. Seek Allah's forgiveness. Indeed, He is the forgiving, the merciful. بسم الله الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد. أبو بكر السجستاني رحمه الله, he's explaining the position of أهل السنة here, the belief of the people who are in the middle, not the extremists who make the Muslims disbelievers and not the other extremists who think that you don't have to have any belief, you don't have to have practice along with your belief in your statement. عن إكرمة عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما قال قال رسول الله صلى الله قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سبحان الله سبحان الله. I forgot the hadith I wanted to use here. عن إكرمة عن ابن عباس قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يزني العبد حين يزني وهو مؤمن ولا يسرق حين يسرق وهو مؤمن ولا يشرب حين يشرب وهو مؤمن ولا يقتل وهو مؤمن. قال عكرمة قلت لابن عباس كيف ينزع الإيمان منه؟ قال هكذا وشبك بين أصابعه ثم أخرجها فإن تاب عاد إليه هكذا وشبك بين أصابعه. أخرجه النسائي وصححه الألباني. On the authority of Ikrama, on the authority of Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما, he said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the servant of Allah that commits zina, fornication, and adultery, he is not a believer, a mu'min, at the time he's committing zina, fornication, or adultery. And when the believer steals, he is not a believer while he's stealing. And when he takes intoxicants, he's not a believer while he's taking intoxicants. And when he kills a believer, he's not a believer when he kills a believer. So Ikramah, the Tabi'i, he's asking the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abdullah ibn Abbas, how does his iman, how does his faith leave him? And Ibn Abbas, he explained like this. He said, put his fingers together, pull them apart, and then he said when he repents, they go back together like that. And this hadith collected authentically by Nasa'i or others, that when the believer is committing the sin, then he leaves from being a believer at that time until he repents and comes back to what is correct. We'll also see this in other hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قال إذا زنى الرجل خرج منه الإيمان وكان عليه كالظلة وإذا أقلع رجع إليه الإيمان. أخرجه أبو داود أو غيره وصححه الألباني. Where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when a man commits a zina, fornication or adultery, then iman leaves him and it's over top of his head like an umbrella or a cloud. And then when he leaves the act, then the iman returns back to him. As we see in this authentic hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, some of the salaf, they used to explain this hadith, they used to say, kharaja min al-imani ila al-islam wa la yukhrijuhu min al-islam illa shirku aw fi riwaya illa kufrun. He says that this hadith means that a person leaves iman and goes to the level of Islam, but he doesn't leave Islam until he actually disbelieves or becomes a mushrik. Whereas Allah Ta'ala says in other verses, قالت الأعراب آمنا قل لم تؤمنوا ولكن قولوا أسلمنا ولما ليدخل الإيمان في قلوبكم. And the desert Arabs say, we believe. Say to them, don't say you believed, don't say you have iman, but rather say you have accepted Islam. Because true iman, true faith, hasn't entered your heart. Because if you have true faith in your heart, it will be expressed on your tongue and with your body parts. And this is what's meant, as Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, he says, saying the same thing of which Abu Bakr al-Sijistani is teaching us, Bukhari says in the Sahih, Babu al-Ma'asi min Amr al-Jahiliyya, wa la yukaffiru sahibuha illa bishirki. Bukhari said, acts of disobedience are from the affairs of al-Jahiliyya, meaning this is what people do before they embrace Islam. But the Muslim who commits these acts are not to be considered a disbeliever, a kafir, except by shirk. This is what Allah intends with this statement, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Indeed, Allah does not forgive that you commit shirk, but He forgives anything less than that to whoever He wills. And this has been clarified in the hadith of Abu Darda رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كل ذنب عسى الله أن يغفره إلا من مات مشركا أو مؤمنا قتل مؤمنا متعمدا. أخرجه أبو داود وصححه الألباني. Where the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, every sin Allah will forgive except that a person dies as a mushrik, or a believer kills a believer intentionally. We benefit from this poem, the correct Muslim belief that we do not consider the Muslims to be disbelievers because of the acts of disobedience that they commit unless they leave Islam and die upon that. Belief or faith and this religion is levels. From the lowest level where iman leaves you and you're simply in a state of Islam because you're not acting like a true believer should act, all the way up into the one who is doing what he's supposed to do in light of Allah's book and the sunnah of his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And then he has the level of paradise like the prophets and messengers. Or as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded the companions of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam because of their iman, because of their faith. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us strong iman and protect us from dying other than on Islam. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-jannah. Oh Allah, we ask you for Jannah. Allahumma ajirna minan nar. Oh Allah, save us from the fire. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. Oh Lord, give us the good in this world and the good in the hereafter and save us from the fire. Hatha wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam wa subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk walhamdulillah. استووا 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 سووا صفوفكم وتراصوا لا تختلفوا فتختلف قلوبكم إن تسوية الصف من تمام الصلاة. استووا 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 سووا صفوفكم وتراصوا لا تختلفوا فتختلف قلوبكم إن تسوية الصف من تمام الصلاة. Straighten the rows, straighten the rows, straighten the rows and fill the gaps. Line up foot to foot and shoulder to shoulder. Don't leave your rows crooked or Allah will divide your hearts. Straightening the rows is a part of perfecting the salah. Istawu, 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 sawu sufufakum wa tarassu la takhtalifu فتختلف قلوبكم إن تسوية الصف من تمام الصلاة. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. قل يا أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Next week, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to have a book bag and school supply giveaway, inshallah ta'ala. Follow what's going on our website at thesunnah.org, inshallah ta'ala. We're also going to have a guest khatib next week, has visited us a number of times in the past. He's going to deliver the Jumu'ah next week, as well as a Friday night lecture, inshallah, tabarak wa ta'ala, as he finishes off the poem from Abu Bakr al-Sijistani, rahimahullah. Some brothers have said to me that there might be some possible questions from the khutbah from time to time. If you do have questions and you come back later on in the evening after Salatul Maghrib, I'll entertain all of your questions pertaining to the khutbah. Or you can call our masjid anytime, inshallah ta'ala, and we can do our best to explain if something isn't clear. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always give us clarity on our religion. Again, visit our website, thesunnah.org. You can always find out what's going on. May Allah accept from everybody. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I forgot to make mention of the month of Al-Muharram has begun, and the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encourages us to fast in this month of Al-Muharram in general, and specifically on the day of Ashura. As he says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَصِيَامُ عَشُورَ أَحْتَسِبُ عَلَى اللَّهِ أَنْ يُكَفِّرَ السَّنَةَ الَّتِي قبله. Or as the Prophet ﷺ says in the hadith of Imam Muslim, I pray that Allah will atone the sins that were committed before the fasting of the day of Ashura, for the fasting of the day of Ashura. The fasting of the day of Ashura is the 10th of Al-Muharram. Fasting Al-Ashura is the 10th of Al-Muharram. The Muslims have differed on which day is the 10th of Al-Muharram. But we'll be fasting, inshallah ta'ala, encouraging the Muslims to fast on the 10th of Al-Muharram. So whichever calendar comes to you, fast on the 10th day of Al-Muharram. May Allah accept from all of us our worship. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.